They're gone, son. We won't be seeing them again.
They were angry at you, weren't they? That's why we had to leave.
They was just good men who turned bad.
What the fuck
I'll
happened
explain
to you?
It to you one
oh,
day.
Oh, freaking slid off the cliff.
Come on.
Seriously. I don't, actually, I can't say I don't like the name Jack. I don't like that. It's a little too simple. Jack.
Come on!
No, it's okay.
Yeah.
Jackson? Is it short for Jackson?
No more talking now, boy. We need to save our energy for that herd. There's the ranch. Come on. Let's see if we can find Mr. McFarland.
Yeah, no, he's right there. Thought he was dead.
Come on, easy up now.
What the fuck? He dived right into the ground. He dove into it.
I thought I'd never see you again. Have our public servants in Blackwater sent you back on another homicidal errand to protect and save us from Lord only knows what?
Thankfully not, sir. I was hoping you might still be able to sell me some cattle.
My boy, it would be a pleasure. Bonnie's out in the crowd now. She'll be more than happy to help you.
Take care now, Mr. McFarland. Good luck. All right, Jack. You're gonna have an important job.
When I doesn't know.
Do my eyes deceive me? A devil walks among us.
I said I'd be back when this was all over, Miss McFarland. After the barn fire, you remember?
Of course I remember. I just didn't believe a word of it. So, you've come for some cattle?
Yeah, I'm finally starting up my farm again. Or trying to, at least.
You'll be fine. You've been taught well. Come on, then.
Okay, how did John start farming originally? Because he seems kind of ass about it.
Come on.
But it looks like Jack has some bit of experience. I hope to Christ you don't have to ride all the way back there.
Move! Let's go!
Remember the buttons. Hey, 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 where you going?
Head for the river, son! Stay together, you dumb animals!
I'm gonna play. We'll go left, then right.
Move on! Move on!
I'll give you a hand.
Good luck, John! Come back and see you sometime!
I will.
So, what happened? Last I heard, you were headed for some exotic escapade in Mexico.
It's a long story! Too long to tell without a drink in my hand.
Back to the riddles, I see. And Mr. Williamson?
Let's just say Bill and I settled our differences. Yeah.
Let's go.
Slow up. Let's move here, my four-legged friends.
Go, you four-legged.
So, is this your boy?
Creans?
Yeah. Say hello to Miss McFarland, Jack.
Hello.
Ah, the arrogance of youth. He gets a little fur on his lip, and he thinks he knows best all of a sudden. Slow it up now.
Looks like you got him under control. I best get back to Pa.
Nice to see you again, Miss McFarland.
What do you mean?
And thanks for everything.
You buddy.
We need to move him across the river.
We're gonna lose some, like, alligators or something.
Let's go.
What? We're in our swamps, so I don't think we would see any.
Come on. Whoa there. Move. You're doing a good job, son. Just lead them straight up the hill towards home.
Will do, Paul.
Easy. Move. Come on.
I bet you some of them are going to split like assholes. Going back, dude? Free to go back. Get to the herd. Get to the herd, but oh.
No stopping. Let's go.
Go.
Come on. Go. Keep it moving.
Okay.
Let's go!
Faster, faster.
Come on! Get going! Come on!
Far out, RV. Oh, man. So I gotta get past this cliff at least.
Hey!
Too many freaking cattle for me. Should've just got like 4 or 5. You can just tie them on ropes and just like walk them. Turn. We get drove off a cliff.
Hold up, Jack. This don't look right. I'll deal with this. Stay with the herd, Jack.
Freaking chubby. Oh, yeah, cow rustlers.
This would be a fair fight if you could shoot straight. I think that's all of them. Jack, wait there, I'm coming. You all right? You're not hurt, are you?
No, I'm fine. I wasn't scared, honest.
I'm sorry you had to see that, son. Those men won't be stealing from anybody else. Jack, head left up the road towards home. Let's go!
Go, you horse. Yeah. I mean, you cows. Being jerks. What are you doing?
Come on!
So, jam the curve straight. Now we're gonna go forward. Hopefully, I don't get the bang up on trees.
Slow down. Move it up.
What are you doing, you rustler, Custler? Oh, or get rustlers on your ass again. And I'll show you a move right then and there. Once you, oh, that are dead right there. Move.
Come on, let's go.
We're only like a foot away. Move.
Get a move on.
This is like the smoothest time I ever had herding cows.
Forward.
I hope this is our house.
Let's go.
Fucking shit. Of course they fuck up right here. They're gonna do a 360 turn, aren't they? Yep.
Easy.
Cows are going through this door, please. Of course, we have one big mix-up.
All right, now lead them into the pen.
Let's go. Hey, slow down, kids. Oh, they're going on their own. What? Really going.
Whoa.
Okay.
Let's go.
Nice work, son.
We made it.
You did real good out there. Go on. Hit your horse and wait for me by the stable. Come on.
To the hitching post.
Whoa there. Did a good job, son. Nice shooting.
Thanks, Pa.
Make a rancher of you yet.
Actually, you know what? He is talking about. He's about 16. I didn't get to see it because the way when they first meet, he looks like he's at shoulder level. And let's go talk to Abigail, the wife. Let's go talk to the wife. My beautiful Abigail. Pestilence.
What you cooking?
Same thing I've been cooking the past 15 years with the hope of poisoning you.
Ain't working so well.
Not yet.
I'll be honest, though. Tastes bad enough to kill a man.
I never was much of a cook, but I did try to be a good wife.
And you have been.
Given what we was and what we came from, I think we've gone and done okay. I look at Jack. I look at him, and I think we've been blessed. Maybe he can be something more.
He's a good kid. He can be whatever he wants to be. He ain't gonna be no frontier gunslinger killing and running no gang, though. That way's over. Railroads and government and motor cars and everything gone and done away with all that.
And he ain't gonna marry no orphaned working girl running with a bunch of hucksters, neither.
If he meets one like you, I hope he'll marry her.
Stop. For an illiterate gunslinger, you sure know how to make a girl blush.
God damn crows! John! You have got to go deal with them. They've broken into the silo again and are eating all the corn out from it.
Of course, my angel.
Wait. Get out of there!
All right, all right.
Come on! Scat!
Mm-hmm. Look at her smiling again. She's happy to see John. Do I have to get up there? No. How does this work with the climate somehow? Or do I just shoot the fucking crows? It's ring, we're just gonna go crows.
Damn it!
I'm gonna kill all these freaking crows. Okay. So I guess I have to kill like a certain percentage of them. Still a lot of damn crows, though. Go help Happy. My beautiful, forceful wife. Used to be a working girl, if you know what I mean. You sure do work. Old friends, new problems.
John, we got a telegram from some lady friend of yours, a Bonnie something or other. Something you ain't telling me?
Bonnie McFarlane. She's a friend. Saved my life when I went after Bill and nearly got myself killed again.
Oh, now you two's in the habit of sending each other letters. How very nice.
It weren't nothing like that. What's it say?
I don't know. I can't. Well, you know I can't read.
Give it here.
Oh, call me illiterate. I can read.
You read that thing out loud.
I ain't hiding nothing. Dear Mr. Marston. Stop. Need corn sacks. Stop. Emergency. Stop. Weevils and moths ate entire county supply. Stop.
Green period.
Need help. Not exactly the most romantic request, now, is it?
I guess not. And she saved your life, you say?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, then you're gonna have to help her and her family out. We've got a plentiful supply of corn sacks over near the silo. About the one thing Uncle didn't manage to have stolen while we was gone.
Okay.
Hurry back, John. And John, what's she like?
You know. A little bit like you, I guess. She's a woman in a man's world.
She's gonna come, isn't she? She's a little jelly. Don't worry, I have no reason to be jelly. If you do, I would rather have Bonnie. She's nicer to me. She doesn't hit me.
Wait.
Try to beat my ass.
Maybe I should meet this McFarlane.
I'm joking.
Woman.
I love
what
the wife.
What are you waiting for? You better
hurry. Play her. Gotta make sure she's extra jelly.
I don't think. wouldn't let you go off again without me.
Fair enough. I'm glad of the company. You only had to ask.
Ask? I was waiting for you to ask me.
I thought you'd want to keep an eye on the fort.
Oh, while you were off cavorting with cowgirls in the next county? I don't think so, John Marston. You only just got home. That Jack has seen enough of me for a lifetime. So, is she married? This Bonnie McFarlane?
No.
What does she look like?
I don't know. Pretty normal, I suppose.
Normal? What? Normal like me?
No. Normal as in two eyes, mouth, nose, that kind of normal. Besides, ain't no woman fine as you.
A little flattery. Now we're finally getting somewhere.
If you find yourself in a hole, the first thing to do is stop digging.
Another pearl of wisdom from John Marston. I sure do miss those.
I never took to you for the jealous type, Abigail.
I ain't jealous, so much as curious.
You heard what she wrote. It's just some corn. She saved my life, and she was decent enough to me, so I owe her this much at least.
How did she save your life, anyway?
She found me half dead on the side of the road and took me to the doctor. Most folks would have left me there.
Half dead from what?
Bill didn't take so kindly to me visiting unannounced.
Bill never did like surprises. How was he?
Same as he was when we left. Angry and dumb. Taking his revenge out on the world. People down there was really scared of him.
Of Bill? You gotta be kidding me. He was only frightening if he was afraid of dumb fools.
Bill weren't so bad, but Dutch went crazy. Bill took it hard.
For a while, we all thought we'd found something right. Better way to live, but it was just a lie. So you saw before they did.
Maybe. But they was still kind of a family.
A family that left you for dead.
Okay, this is the last mission,
John.
You know,
and they hated you for
time limit. Besides that little stopwatch on the top screen.
Who?
Those government bastards.
Recording screen is 2 hours long.
I ain't sure. They kept their eyes covered there and back.
I hate
can't have been too far from here, though.
Long sessions,
right?
I mean, editing long sessions.
It ain't the first time I've had a gun to my head, John.
Monumental
You're
amount of time.
Your marriage proposal.
Very fun.
So, they learned pretty quick what would happen if they laid a finger on me.
I think I just killed the freaking dog.
You came. Thank you so much. We lost the entire harvest.
Miss McFarlane, I'd like you to meet my wife. Abigail.
Oh, ain't you quite the gentleman all of a sudden? It's a pleasure to meet you, Mrs. Marston. Likewise. Thank you for saving my husband's life and for teaching the miserable goats manners, among other things.
I didn't teach him anything. I know better than to try to change a man. You should meet my father.
Oh, people can change, Miss McFarlane. John and I have to believe that more than anybody.
This is a decent first harvest for you, John. You should be proud. That's good land you got there.
How are you feeling, Mrs. Marston? From what your husband told me, it must have been awful for you.
I've been through worse, and I knew he'd be back before too long. He can't cook a meal to save his life.
Abigail, in my darkest hours, when I was most homesick, just the thought of one of your rat meat stews kept me pushing forward.
Well, about as amusing as a weeping saddle sore, ain't he, Mr. Farland? If you're gonna start yammering about women's work, John, I'd say you might be in the wrong company.
I'd say so, too.
I never felt so outnumbered.
Mm-hmm. I love how they walk with the sack so easily. They could have probably carried two at a time. Bonnie watches us. Aww. He's sad.
Ma'am?
Dax Marston. Yeah, she likes Marston. Too bad he's married. Another beautiful lady.
So that was the famous Bonnie.
That was her, all right.
She's pretty.
She's normal, like I said.
Well, you always wanted to be a rancher. I'd have thought
she be just your thing. The perfect rancher's wife, if I ever saw one.
I already got a rancher's wife.
I'm only teasing. I like her, and I'm glad she saved your life. Most of the time, anyway.
The McFarlands are good people.
She did blush better than a shepherd's sunset when she saw you, though.
I have that effect on women.
You clearly had one too many blows to the head.
You ain't wrong about that, Mrs. Marston.
Have that effect on women.
That's kind of rare.
I would say so too.
That'll be us someday. As soon as we get back on our feet.
I don't know, John. How many times can we start again? An outlaw and a working girl. We ain't exactly farmers.
We are now. Forget that life. It's over.
Do you really believe that?
We have to. It's the only way we'll ever have a future.
The life we led, that doesn't go away. Never over. You think those government men are just gonna leave us alone now?
The old gang's dead. I did what they asked.
And that's it? A life to cry for killing?
We're back together, ain't we?
Until they decide you owe them something else.
Sometimes I think I was the stupid one for believing I could get out. Maybe Josh, Bill, and Javier were just being honest with themselves.
You ain't perfect, John, and I sure ain't. But you're better than they are, than they were.
Maybe we can't change. We gotta try, for Jack's sake. Even if we have to start again 100 times. Better than going back to where we were.
Yeah, freaking gunslinger.
Angry, upset. He's been through a lot.
I hope he's gonna be all right.
It's gonna take time. For a while, his world was safe. Normal, even. Then it got turned upside down again.
He ain't saying much about it.
I've tried to talk to him, but how do you explain any of this? What do you say when he asks about Uncle Bill and Uncle Dutch? They were family when he was a little boy.
He hides away in those books of his.
Wouldn't you? It ain't like the real world's done him any favors. He's just been kidnapped. He grew up with the gang. That's no life for a boy.
We did our best to protect him.
Come on, John. He saw things no boy should see.
I wonder how many people were illiterate back then.
We did good
maybe
today,
like...
John.
25-35%
people. I guess I better go fix us
like
something to eat.
The 1 or 2%. Like, there's like a large portion of people back then who couldn't read. What's the point of reading when you're out doing other stuff? Actually, you know, I'll do one more thing. Do I want to help Ulysses or Jack? Yeah, let's do Jack Boy. My son. Let's do Ulysses. Or not, so. Oh. They're moving to their spots. We got a knife, Jack? Who got you that knife? Did I do it, young Jack Boy? Damn, I just pushed my son. Love you, Jack. Still love you, bud. Looks just like me. Same walk. He's gonna lean up on the tree, right? Really, Jack's not ready? Ulysses is ready. Jack, you gotta be ready. I don't wanna talk to Ulysses. Ulysses is terrible. Jackie.
Hello, sir.
Man, screw you, Jack. Fuck it, Ulysses. Let's talk to the dirty old man. Sweat. By sweat and toil. This is the last one we're gonna do for today. This dirty ass mustache. Heard of soap and water. Kick his ass.
Get
Kick
up,
him.
Old man.
I am up.
Get up!
There, I'm up. Well,
thank the good Lord you're back. Nothing worse for an old man than sleeping in the warm afternoon sun.
You want a long sleep, Uncle? That can be arranged. It'll cost me less than food.
You always was a hard and nasty man, John Marston.
You always was a useless, conniving thief. And where's them cattle? Did you take them to pasture?
It's coming around to that.
When exactly?
It's easy to pick on the elderly. It's easy, but it ain't dignified.
Come on, old man. Do this together.
I swear, old man, uncle. His name's not Ulysses, his uncle. Thinking about Ulysses Grant. Was he president? I'm dumb as fuck, he was president, sorry. Don't know which one.
Move him out!
A farce bastard. Yes, you're taking him to the Great Plains, probably. It's the only pasture I can think of. Really? Freaking dude, seriously.
Whoa there!
Oh shit.
Come on! Let's get him out to pasture!
No.
Move! Come on!
Move, you stupid. Stupid. Boobas. Yeah, take him out here.
Yeah!
Steady now, you dumb cow!
I wonder how long. How long does it take to build a fence around, like, this area back in the day? Because now you can have like pre-built fences. You can just set up and link.
Easy.
Hey, hey. What are you doing? Get back to the group, dude.
Let's go.
For it to move faster.
Come on, come on, come on.
Stay tight.
Get going. Come on.
Oh, an uncle. Oh, an uncle.
Whoa.
Keep on, uncle, you dumb cows.
Hey.
Ooh. Don't make me get milk. Don't make me get milk. What are you doing? Don't make
Let's
me
go.
Get milk. I will make you lactate.
Come on, easy up there.
I don't know what the hell I'm saying.
Whoa there. Let's go.
I feel like...
God
yeah.
damn it! Christ, John! They're stampeding!
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Jesus, we lost them fucking cows.
again.
Come on, cow, we're going.
Go.
Round up freaking stragglers now. Come on, boy.
Come on.
Why am I doing all
Those guys, yep, okay.
Let's go!
13 cowboys left. I'll pop a cap in your butt cheeks, go. Get to the group, because we gotta ride.
Alright, you stay front!
Get in formation. I'll throw a flame bottle at you. Fire bottle.
Come on! Keep it moving!
Go, 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 go!
Move. Let's move here, my four-legged friends! Move! Let's go!
Fasten the uncle. Uncle's getting on my nerve, dude.
Stay together, you dumb animal!
Anyway. It's right there. The pasture's right there.
Slow it up now.
There you go.
Over here. Over here. We're missing two cows, though.
You look after the herd. I'll ride back.
No thanks. You got your pound of flesh from me today.
What do I get for 13 cows herded?
Yeah! Come on!
Get up on some flatland. Oh. Where the buffaloes roam. I read the song. There are some buffaloes. Anyways, guys, I would thank you guys for joining me for this session. This session of Red Dead Redemption. This session, we freaking destroyed Dutch and his gang and watched, what is his name, Nasta, get shot in the freaking base, which I knew was gonna happen. Usually happens to anyone who helps me along the way. And anyone who's an asshole apparently lives, like Dixon, or McDougal. They all get to live. Don't know how, but I got to see my wife again, return back to my normal life. But again, Marston keeps on pointing out that, like, this life's over. We'll never go back to that again. Which I feel like that's gonna prelude to something. Again, I play the game, so I know, I'm just saying, it's gonna prelude to something. Anyways, guys, thank you for joining me. For Red Dead Redemption, I'll catch you guys in the next one. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Don't forget to share the video. I'll see you in the next one. Marky Mark, out.